Hey you guys, I'm Molly with Design Loves Detail, and today we are talking about neutral paint colors, which is so exciting. These are my favorites, so stay tuned for more. While you are here, be sure to subscribe and hit the bell if you haven't done that yet. And we will kind of get into the colors. So over the years, I have used I have kind of a handful of whites that I've used in both my homes and my clients' homes that I think are really good ones. And I'll tell you why I like each one. And so hopefully it will help you in narrowing down whites for your own home. For our last home, for the exterior brick, that's one I get a lot of questions on. It's actually Farrow & Ball's Shaded White. And that is the same color that I used on our kitchen cabinets. And it's honestly, I wouldn't describe it as white when you see it on the paint chip, but it's got a lot of like saturation to it, kind of in that grayish range where it's really nice because when you photograph it or even when it's outside on the brick, it does look a little bit lighter. And so it doesn't get washed out like some whites do. And that has been a really good one. I recommend it for, I love it on cabinets. I love it on the exterior, like I said. So that's a good one that is like a white, but not too white. I usually go with warmer whites for the walls, just so that it doesn't feel too sterile. Some of my favorites there are Benjamin Moore's White Dove. I used this in our basement of the last home, and then I've also used it in client projects, and it is very pretty. It's kind of a creamy tone and has a little bit of depth to it. It still feels like an off-white. The next one that I really love is Benjamin Moore's Swiss Coffee. And it has a nice, it's even a little bit richer toned than the White Dove. So if you want a little bit more saturation, that's a good one. I did that with the Super White trim. So you can see there's a little contrast there between the two. And so it has enough difference in the color there to work with the true white, which brings us to Super White. It's the truest white, I think, one of the truest whites out there without having like a blue undertone or anything weird. It's just a really true white. And so I have actually used it on walls. I'll show you a couple examples of that. And I don't mind it on walls. It doesn't feel too sterile to me. It is one that is more of a white if you want truly white. So there's that one. And then I also, for this home, you'll see behind me, I also really love this one. It's a new one I hadn't used, but it's Benjamin Moore's China White. And it does look like the China dishes, like the fine China. It has kind of a grayish undertone. So that's really nice about it. Sometimes it looks like a little bit warmer color. Sometimes it has a little bit more of leans on that grayish side. So it's interesting in that it's not a creamy tone. So it doesn't feel yellowish at all. Its undertone is grayish. And so I have loved it for that because it brings a little bit of richness and saturation to the space, but still feels airy and nice and bright and pretty. And it's interesting. It's like kind of a chameleon color, depending on different lighting. It can look warmer and it can look a little bit cooler in other lights. So it's kind of, if you guys remember Revere Pewter, that's kind of like a darker tone, but it was one of the most popular colors a few years back because it kind of works with both cool and warm tones. It kind of goes back and forth. And this is almost like a whitish version of that. You want to try it in the space, just like with any paint. I always recommend trying it on the actual wall because your paint colors are affected by the direction of your lighting, the lighting in your home, the actual light fixtures, and a lot of different factors. And so trying a sample is really just the best way to go. I know some people try to cut that corner, but if you want it to look good and you don't want it to be an expensive mistake, just go ahead and roll it on the wall before you commit. And it's like $6 or $7 for a little that size of paint can to do a sample. So highly recommend that. And anyways, this Benjamin Moore's China White is such a pretty one. I did it on the trim and the walls and the ceiling. So in this case, I was trying to be cost effective. We were of course doing this home initially as like a flip project. And so I wanted to be really budget conscious, but I have to tell you, I really do love the look of the single color paint. So I wouldn't feel like it's necessarily like a downgrade from the two or three tone paint options. Like what I wanted to do with this space is I really wanted your eye to travel seamlessly from wall to ceiling because there's so much volume in the ceilings and I wanted it to not make your eye stop where the wall meets the ceiling. So this is one way that you can kind of keep that a really smooth transition is just going with that single tone paint, and I've been really happy with it here. Those are right now my favorite white colors. There's also a couple others that I haven't used, but I've seen them used a lot and they are good ones to look at, which is Benjamore Simply White and Chantilly Lace. Both of those are really popular ones as well, which you could grab samples of if you're trying different whites. Those are my favorites in the neutral paint zone. So thank you guys for watching and be sure to subscribe and hit the bell to be notified of when our next video is live.